butter chicken from scratch in 30 minutes. Let's get it. Look, you don't have to be a chef to make butter chicken. I'm gonna show you a fast and delicious recipe that you can make any night of the week. The rice actually takes longer than the chicken to cook, so that's the first thing we're gonna do. Step one for perfect rice, you gotta rinse it. A lot of people don't know this, but most rices need to be rinsed. There's a lot of excess starch on there, and actually if you cook with all that excess starch, you get more of a mushy, gummier rice. The way I like to rinse my rice is I get a strainer and I just dump it in, and you're gonna need really cold water. It's that simple. And use your hands to kinda mix the rice, and you could see the cloudy water coming out because it's not clear, and I really rinse this until I see clear water. There it is, guys, cleaned rice, ready to rock for cooking. And now this is where the trick comes in. This is where the magic happens. So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna take your hand and you're gonna make the tiger claw. That's what I like to call it. And you're gonna pat that rice down in a nice flat layer. I don't use measuring cups when I make rice. I use my finger. That's my measuring cup. So let me show you. What you're gonna do after you pat your rice down, you're gonna add water and you're gonna pour it in slowly. You don't wanna pour it in crazy because then it'll bust up the beautiful little flat layer of rice you just made. And then after you add a little bit of water, you're gonna go ahead and pat it down. And I did a good job rinsing because my water is clear. I can see my rice. I'm gonna use my fingertip and I'm gonna touch the surface of the rice. And that water should touch that line on my finger right there. And that looks good to me. I learned this trick from a Thai chef that I worked with long ago. And he said to me, "Brother Jordan, don't use a measuring cup when making rice, use your finger." And it's never steered me wrong. We're gonna get this on high heat covered. We're gonna bring it to a boil, and once it hits a boil, we're gonna turn it down to a simmer. You're gonna set that timer for 15 minutes, taste the rice. If it needs a little bit more, it won't need more than a minute, 16 minutes max. So to dice this onion, it doesn't really matter the size you go for, but what does matter is that it's even, because it is gonna get sauteed at some point. To dice the onion, we're gonna make a couple little horizontal slices in that onion. So I like to set my onion down and I almost just put my hand on top to hold it in place. But one thing you'll notice is I'm not slicing through the whole onion. I'm leaving a little area where I'm not cutting through, and that's gonna give me something to hold on to. Then you flip that onion towards yourself, and then I follow the natural lines of the onion. And again, I wanna keep these as even as possible. But as you can see, I'm not chopping through the entire onion. I'm stopping about a little, about an inch from the tip there. Now the hard part's done with chopping an onion. Now all we have to do is run our knife through, but you wanna keep it even. And voila, perfectly diced onions. It's been 15 minutes. Let's take a look at how our rice is doing. All the water is gone. That's a great sign. I just take my fork and I just kind of fluff the top a little bit to see. I taste it. It's tender, it's fluffy. There's no bite to it. That is perfectly cooked rice in 15 minutes. So now we're gonna toast our spices, and that's key to making a great buttered chicken. Okay, so we got garam masala here. We're gonna start off with 4 teaspoons of that. And we're gonna go right into a dry pan. Garam masala is a seasoning blend packed with cumin, coriander, cinnamon, black pepper, and a little cardamom. It's great with chicken, it's great with lamb, and I love it on cauliflower. We're also gonna add 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, some ground ginger, some turmeric, and some crushed red pepper. Now, butter chicken's not typically spicy, but if you want it a little spicier, don't be afraid to add a little bit more crushed red pepper. That's where the heat's gonna come from in this dish. So now we're gonna toast up our spices, and we're gonna do this on a medium-high flame. It's only gonna take about a minute. This is gonna heighten the flavors, give it a whole new depth of flavor. So the entire room smells like spices, so that means that these spices are ready, and now I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of butter right to that pan. And now we're gonna start to get our sauce base made. This is where we're gonna get our first layer of flavor. So right now these spices are mixing with that butter, almost making this beautiful toasted spice, almost butter base. It's so good. So when your butter's all melted, that means it's ready for onion. So use your handy dandy bench scraper and get your onion right in that beautiful spiced butter. Give that a mix. And then we're gonna saute these onions, I would say 2 to 3 minutes. We just wanna soften them up a bit. There's nothing like the smell of onions and warm spices and butter. They should make a candle out of this, seriously though. So it's been about 2 minutes. My onions are soft, which means it's ready for tomato. You wanna be careful at this step not to burn your spices, so make sure you're not really cooking those onions more than 2-3 minutes. So I'm using petite diced tomatoes in a can. The reality is though, when you are using canned tomato, make sure there's no seasoning in that can. Sometimes they add oregano and parsley. Those are all great things, but not for this type of dish. So what I love about this dish is that it's a one-pot meal. You can make the entire thing right in the same pan. right where our sauce is cooking is the same exact pan where our chicken's gonna go in, the finished product and all. So now we're ready for the blender. The reason you wanna blend this, my version of buttered chicken is a very smooth buttered chicken. I like mine really no chunk, no grit. So you're gonna blend your tomato and onion mixture. It's gonna lighten up the color a little bit too naturally, which is really nice. But again, I like a smooth buttered chicken. So you're gonna give this a blend for about 10 seconds until everything is super smooth. And that's it, that easy. Butter chicken base ready. And this is my favorite part of butter chicken. I mean this. Is that just getting that butter chicken facial. That's nice. It's good. Take a sip. So you're gonna add that simmering sauce now back to the pan. Turn that flame on low. Now, one thing when making curries like this, the last thing you're gonna wanna do is A, burn this sauce, or B, sometimes it separates because we're gonna be adding some cream later, and these types of sauces tend to wanna separate at times. So just leave it on a super low flame. As you guys can see, I have a nice little simmer going. Give it a stir, and you can see the thickness already, the richness, the warmness, the spices. I mean, it is killer in here. So once that sauce is back at a simmer, that means it's chicken time. I got some cube chicken breast here, and you're just gonna empty that entire bowl and try to coat all of that chicken in that beautiful, rich, spicy sauce. I'm putting my chicken right in this simmer sauce because I want it poached. I want it cooked kind of gentle. And it's gonna also soak up a lot more of that sauce and a lot more of those flavors. So you're gonna cook this chicken for about 8 to 10 minutes or until it's cooked through all the way. So my chicken's done, that means it's time to finish this beast. All we're gonna need is another 2 tablespoons of butter, hence the name butter chicken. Get that right in that skillet. Now heavy cream is what gives butter chicken its gorgeous finished color. When I think butter chicken, I think orangey red kind of beautiful, bright, rich tasting. Right now it's a little bit on the dark side. This cream is really what's gonna make it pop. Now always when you're adding cream to any hot skillet, like I said earlier, turn the flame down low. The last thing we wanna do is curdle or separate this beautiful, beautiful dish. But that color is looking really good. Wait till it just all mixes together. It's gonna be gorgeous. So the last thing we need for this buttered chicken is to season it with a little bit of salt. If you remember, we didn't use any salt at all at any point. Now it's time to plate this up. Looks great. Get that in your bowl. The sauce looks velvety, it looks rich, looks creamy, it looks great. So we're just gonna finish this off with some cilantro. So I'm gonna serve mine with some grilled naan and some basmati rice. You're not gonna wanna miss this recipe. It's flavorful, it's delicious, and it's easy and quick. If you want more recipes and tricks from the McCormick Test Kitchens, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Well, I can't wait anymore. I gotta eat this butter chicken now before it gets cold. It's been real. We'll see you guys at the next recipe.